The Constitution of India, Preamble. We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution.
The Constitution of India. A Constitution is a kind of charter that guides the government on how to rule the country. The Constitution of India contains the rules, responsibilities and duties that must be followed by the Indian government as well as by all the citizens living in India. The Constitution of India basically sets out the fundamental rights and the fundamental duties of the citizens of India and the directive principles of state policies. It is considered to be the lengthiest documented constitution that can be found in any country around the world. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, the chairman of the drafting committee, is broadly regarded as the main architect of Indian Constitution. The Indian Constitution imparts constitutional supremacy and not parliamentary preeminence, since it was formed by Constituent Assembly instead of the Indian Parliament. However, the Indian Parliament cannot override the Constitution since it was accepted by its citizens with a declaration in its preamble. The Constitution of India was accepted on 26 November 1949 by the Indian Constituent Assembly. However, it became effective from 26 January 1950 onwards. The Constitution clearly affirms India as a secular, socialist, sovereign and democratic republic, ensuring that its citizens get liberty, equality and justice. It also attempts to promote brotherhood among every citizen of India and sees no difference in people on basis of caste, creed, color, religion, etc. The Constituent Assembly drafted the Constitution of India and was chosen by the elected members of assemblies of the province. The 299 member assembly took roughly about 3 years to draft the Indian Constitution and held almost 11 sessions for a period of 165 days to create the supreme document of India. It becomes very important that we pass the knowledge to our future generations about the struggle and hard work of our great leaders in achieving an independent, democratic, self-reliant country and helping us to live in the era of New India. And Constitution Day is one of the days which helps us to pass this flame of knowledge to our future generations.
Vallabh Bhai Jhaveri Bhai Patel, 1875 to 1950, born in Gujarat, Minister of Home, Information and Broadcasting in the interim government, lawyer and leader of Bardoli Peace and Satyagraha. Played a decisive role in the integration of the Indian princely states, later Deputy Prime Minister. Abul Kalam Azad, 1888 to 1958, born in Saudi Arabia, educationist, author and theologian, scholar of Arabic, Congress leader, active in the national movement, opposed Muslim separatist politics, later education minister in the first Union cabinet. T.T. Krishnamachari, 1899 to 1974, born in Tamil Nadu, member of drafting committee, entrepreneur and Congress leader, later finance minister in the Union cabinet. Rajendra Prasad, 1884 to 1963, born in Bihar, president of the Constituent Assembly, lawyer, known for his role in Champaran Satyagraha, 3 times the president of Congress, later the first president of India. Jaipal Singh, 1903 to 1970, born in Jharkhand, a sportsman and educationist, captain of the first national hockey team, founder president of Adivasi Mahasabha, later founder of Jharkhand Party. H.C. Mukherjee, 1887 to 1956, born in Bengal, Vice Chairman of the Constituent Assembly, reputed author and educationist, Congress leader, member of All India Christian Council and Bengal Legislative Assembly, later Governor of West Bengal. G. Durgabai Deshmukh, 1909 to 1981, born in Andhra Pradesh, advocate and public activist for women's emancipation, founder of Andhra Mahila Sabha, Congress leader, later founder chairperson of Central Social Welfare Board. Baldev Singh, 1901 to 1961, born in Haryana, a successful entrepreneur and leader of the Panthik Akali Party in the Punjab Assembly, a nominee of the Congress in the Constituent Assembly, later Defence Minister in the Union Cabinet. Kanhaiya Lal Maniklal Munshi, 1887 to 1971, born in Gujarat, advocate, historian and linguist, Congress leader and Gandhian, later Minister in the Union Cabinet, founder of Swatantra Party. Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar, 1891 to 1956, born in Madhya Pradesh, chairman of the drafting committee, social revolutionary thinker and agitator against caste divisions and caste-based inequalities, later law minister in the first cabinet of post-independence India, founder of Republican Party of India. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, 1901 to 1953, born in West Bengal, minister for industry and supply in the interim government, educationist and lawyer, active in Hindu Mahasabha, later founder president of Bharatiya Jan Sangh. Jawaharlal Nehru, 1889 to 1964, born in Uttar Pradesh, prime minister of interim government, lawyer and Congress leader, advocate of socialism, democracy and anti-imperialism, later first prime minister of India. Sarojini Naidu, 1879 to 1949, born in Andhra Pradesh, poet, writer and political activist, among the foremost women leaders in the Congress, later governor of Uttar Pradesh. Somnath Lahiri, 1901 to 1984, born in West Bengal, writer and editor, leader of the Communist Party of India, later member of West Bengal Legislative Assembly.
Fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are those rights which are essential for intellectual, moral, and spiritual development of individuals. As these rights are fundamental or essential for existence and all-around development of individuals, hence called as fundamental rights. These are enshrined in Part 3, Articles 12 to 35 of the Constitution of India. These include individual rights common to most, such as equality before the law, freedom of speech and expression, religious and cultural freedom, peaceful assembly, freedom to practice religion, and the right to constitutional remedies for the protection of civil rights by means of writs such as habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, certiorari, and quo warranto. Fundamental duties. The fundamental duties are defined as the moral obligations of all citizens to help promote a spirit of patriotism and to uphold the unity of India. These duties set out in Part 4A of the Constitution concern individuals and the nation. Like the directive principles, they are not enforceable by courts unless otherwise made enforceable by parliamentary law.
The directive principles of the state policy, embodied in Part 4 of the Constitution, are the directions given to the state to guide the establishment of an economic and social democracy as proposed by the preamble. They set forth the humanitarian and socialist instructions that were the main aim of social revolution envisaged in India by the Constituent Assembly. The state is expected to keep these principles in mind while framing the laws and policies, even though they are non-justiciable in nature. The doctrine of separation of powers is a part of the basic structure of the Indian Constitution. Hence, no law and amendment can be passed violating it. The system of checks and balances is essential for the proper functioning of the three organs of the government. Different organs of the state impose checks and balances on the other. The following examples illustrate the checks and balances. Judiciary exercises judicial review over the legislative and executive actions. Judiciary has the power to void laws passed by the parliament. Similarly, it can declare the unconstitutional executive actions as void. Legislatures review the functioning of the executive. Executive appoints the judges. The legislative branch removes the judges. It can also alter the basis of the judgment while adhering to the constitutional limitation.
Today, on the auspicious day of Democratic India, we, the students of India, pledge that we will perform our duty with utmost sincerity and devotion to our motherland. We will show our gratitude towards our parents, teachers, society, and to our country for providing us the ambience of learning. We promise to work hard to revive the pristine glory of India. We promise to abide by all the laws of the country, and we also resolve to maintain peace and harmony. We will strive earnestly for the growth and prosperity of our Mother India. We pray to Mother India to give us strength to fulfill our resolve.